फॉर मोर अपडेट्स सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल।
या हाय हेलो वेलकम टू माय ड्रीम्स एकेडमी दिलशिख नगर या मायसेल्फ पुरुषोत्तम गंधम। सो हियर इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर अपीयर्ड इन TSSPDCL AE 2020 क्वेश्चन पेपर। सो दिस TSSPDCL AE एग्जाम इज हेल्ड ऑन जुलाई 17th। सो फॉर ऑल इलेक्ट्रिकल स्टूडेंट्स दोज हु आर हैविंग डिप्लोमा क्वालिफिकेशन, सो दे हैव सब इंजीनियरिंग एग्जाम TSSPDCL सब इंजीनियरिंग एग्जाम जुलाई 31st। सो ऑलरेडी मन की AE एग्जाम कंप्लीट అయింది కాబట్టి सो ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్‌ప్లెయిన్ what type of questions we got in analog and digital electronics in TSSPDCL AE. So this video help you for sub engineering as well as further AE examinations. So here in analog and digital electronics actually we got a total 7 marks out of 7, 2 questions from digital electronics. So first I will explain like what are the two digital electronic questions and how we need to solve in a easy manner. But in AE, TSSPDCL AE, so I expected like some difficulty questions, but this time in TSSPDCL July 17th we got some complete basic questions from digital only. So why? Because to solve those two questions, so we require nearly 5 seconds. 5 seconds time is enough to solve those two questions. So here I will discuss those two questions. Why? Because this video is completely helpful for sub engineering students. Why? Because so for sub engineering also you will get some questions from analog, digital as well as microcontroller. So ee video chusinaka so meek sub engineering ki next July 31st ki so manam etla prepare avochu ani oka సింపుల్ ఐడియా క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది. సో ఇక్కడ ది ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఈజ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ ఆఫ్ టూ బైనరీ నెంబర్స్. సో దే ఆర్ 1010 అండ్ 1101. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఎవ్రీ స్టూడెంట్ సో దే కెన్ సాల్వ్ ఈజీలీ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. వై? బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కంప్లీట్లీ బేసిక్ క్వశ్చన్. సో నాకు తెలిసి ఇది ఏఈ లెవెల్ క్వశ్చన్ అయితే కాదు. సో ఈవెన్ ఈ సెట్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో ఇవ్వాల్సిన క్వశ్చన్, లైక్ డిప్లొమా రేంజ్లో ఇవ్వాల్సిన క్వశ్చన్, సో మనకి ఏఈ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో వచ్చింది. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఆన్సర్ సార్? సో దిస్ ఈజ్ 1010 ఈజ్ గివెన్, సో యూ కెన్ మల్టిప్లై సో వాట్ ఎవర్. సో హియర్ 1101 సింప్లీ ఇన్ ద మల్టిప్లికేషన్, విచ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్? ఇట్ ఈస్ బైనరీ మల్టిప్లికేషన్. సో ఇన్ బైనరీ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ ఇఫ్ యూ మల్టిప్లై విత్ 0 ద కంప్లీట్ answer is 0, and if you multiply with 1 you will get the same value. Okay, if you multiply with 0 so it is everything will become 0, if you multiply with 1 so you will get the same value. So first so I will go with 0, so if I multiply with 0 so here this is the result, and then after we need to multiply with 1. So if we multiply, so what you will get generally? So 1101 you will get. So here యాక్చువల్గా ఒకవేళ మల్టిప్లికేషన్లో జనరల్గా మనకి ఏమొస్తుంది అంటే షిఫ్ట్ అండ్ యాడ్ మెథడ్. ఇక్కడ మనం ఏం చూస్తున్నాం సార్? సో షిఫ్ట్ అండ్ యాడ్, యాక్చువల్గా అది బేసిక్ క్వశ్చన్, సో ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్ పేపర్స్లో వచ్చింది. సో ఇక్కడ ఏంటంటే డైరెక్ట్ మనకి ప్రాబ్లమే వచ్చింది. సో నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి జస్ట్ 0000 దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ 1, సో వాట్ యూ విల్ గెట్? 1101. సో what function we need to perform in multiplication? Just shift and add. If you shift and add, so what you will get here? 0, you will get 0 here, you will get 1 here, you will get 0 here. So this is 1 1, you will get 0 again here, carry 1. so instead of here I'm taking, this is the carry. So again 2 ones, again you will get 0, so again you will get carry. So again 2 ones, so you will get 0 here, so again carry, again 0, again carry. So you should take 1 here. So what is the answer here? 100010. So option A is the right answer, but this is a basic question guys. Sir, for those who are preparing for sub engineering, so the students you never expect like these questions in your examination. So here we have some subtraction as well as division, and along with that binary addition and 2's complement subtraction, 1's complement subtraction, just go with that. And and moreover in digital we have some other, actually in AE so we got 2 questions from basics only, like binary number systems nunche manaku 2 questions vachnai. But for sub engineering students better to prepare number system, boolean algebra, basic gates, combinational logic circuits, sequential logic circuits, and along with that memories and converters, analog to digital, digital to analog converters. Okay, and next one more question you got in AE TSSP DCL. So that is also a very simple question. The question is what? So we need to convert a decimal number to hexadecimal. So here we have a conversion, that is 185. So this number is presented in decimal number system. So where we need to convert? We need to convert into hexadecimal. So we know hexadecimal is nothing but what? Base 16. What is the value of base? That is 16. So what we need to do? Simply we know that. So whenever we need to convert, whenever we need to, remember this point, whenever we need to convert decimal to any other system, whether it is hexadecimal, you need to divide the integer value with the base value, or octal, you need to divide the integer value with base value. So octal ante manam dentham divide cheyal sir, 8 toni. Binary ante 2 toni. Ikkada em unna sir, hexadecimal kabatti, so you can divide with hexadecimal, that is 16. So I can go with 16. So 16 ones are. So ikkada 16 1, so what you will get sir? So here 16, so what you will get? 25. So 25 ante again I will take 16 ones are only. So in 25, so if you subtract, that is 25 minus 16, what you will get? What is the remainder here? What is the remainder sir? Simply that is 9. Remainder and the 9. But in hexadecimal, try to remember, in hexadecimal, hexadecimal will varies from 0 to 15. So we can call it as F. We can call it as F. So 0 to 9 okay. 0 to 9 okay. But 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we need to take as alphabets, we know very well. So that is A, B, C, D, E, F. So now what you got here? 11. 11 means what? B. So what is the answer here? B9. B9 is the answer. So where we have B is the right answer, that is B9. These two are the some basic questions. So in TSSP DCL AE paper. But all sub engineering aspirants, try to prepare some beyond these problems, like this is from number systems only, but try to prepare so some other topics in digital electronics. Okay, and next we'll see analog electronic questions. So in analog electronics we got 5 questions among 5. So here we have a question. So we have a question from Gina diode. So in this question we need to find the minimum resistance value. Simply we can say load resistance. We need to find. So what is the question here we got? So the question is what? So here the GNR voltage, which is having a voltage of 6 volts, GNR diode with a GNR voltage of 6 volts at zero resistance and knee current. So that is knee current is 5 milliamps is given. And what is to find? So we need to find the minimum value of the load resistance, load resistance, so that the voltage across the diode does not fall below the 6 volts. Ante Gina diode voltage 6 volts ki below fall avvakunda, so minimum resistance manam enta maintain cheyachu. So how much resistance we need to maintain. Okay, so simply we can see here, so it is a simple question. So here first we need to calculate the resistance. So in the problem already we know that, so knee current of Gina diode, so knee current of Gina diode, that is 5 milliamps. So and here the given potential and the voltage is 8.5 volts and here the GNR voltage is 6 volts and here the resistance is 100 ohms. So from this we need to find the IS. First what you need to find? IS. So what is mean by IS sir? How we can write? So that is 8.5 minus 6 by. So 6 by. So what is the resistance here? So that is 100. So here what you will get? So here you will get 25 milliamps. So ento sun sir, 25 milliamps you will get. So just go with the calculations. So here we got IS is equals to 25 milliamps. Then we need to find the load current IL, so that this current will produce us the minimum resistance value across the diode. So here IS is equals to what? IS is equals to 25 milliamps and IZ, that is knee current, is 20 milliamps. So IL, whereas IL is equals to what? IS minus IZ. So what you will get? 25 milliamps minus 5 milliamps. So here what is 20 milliamps? Enter sir, 20 milliamps. Now IL is equal to 20 milliamps. So now we got IL. Okay. So the resistance, the minimum resistance value. So that is RL is equals to minimum resistance value. RL is equals to voltage, GNR voltage, that is 6. So simply we can say VZ by IL. Emanachu sir. So you can write like this, VZ by IL. So VZ is 6 volts and IL is 20 milliamps. So I can write 6000 by 20. I can write, why? Because this milliamps. So here, so you can get cancel, and what you will get here, it is 300. So what is the value of minimum resistance value? Okay, so that the voltage across the GNR diode does not fall below the 6 volts. Ante, so 6 volts kante below fall avagudu ante, so minimum enta maintain cheyal sir? So it should maintain 300 ohms. So what is the answer here? So D is the answer. Okay, so try to understand the problem. So here in this problem, it is a very simple problem. So simply you need to calculate the IL value with that EL value. So you can get the RL easily, that is load resistance. Okay, and next to one more question, that is the voltage gain. Operational amplifier, feedback amplifiers nunchi question idi. The voltage gain of an amplifier without feedback, with feedback. Then determine the negative feedback factor beta. So here what you got? So here you got a value. So that is 100. And the next one is closed loop. So closed loop gain, simply we can say open loop gain anochu sir. Open loop gain ante without feedback. Closed loop gain ante with feedback. So what is the value? It is 50. Okay, so the given value, sir. So without feedback is 100, with feedback is 50. What we need to calculate? We need to calculate beta. So to calculate this beta, first we should know the voltage gain formula of negative feedback amplifier. Here your question is negative feedback amplifier. So for negative feedback amplifier, so the gain, negative feedback amplifier gain. So which gain? Closed loop gain. So closed loop gain is equals to A by 1 plus A beta. So in this formula, we need to find the beta value. Why? Because we have these two values, open loop gain as well as closed loop gain. So how we can find the beta value from this? So see here. So here I can write. So here closed loop gain ACL plus A beta into ACL into A beta I can write, which is equals to A. So in the next step, so I can write like ACL A beta is equals to A minus ACL. So if you take numerator, then what is the beta? Beta should be A minus ACL by, that is A into ACL. A minus ACL by A into ACL. So you can substitute the values here. So what is beta? Simply beta is equal to what is the formula? A minus ACL. A means what? 100. Minus ACL means what? 50 by. So next, A into 100 into 50. 100 into 50. So you can like, which is nothing but what? So 50 by 5000. So what is the value here? It is 0.05. The feedback factor beta value is 0.05 you will get. So this is the answer, simple answer. So the answer is 0.05. So we can easily solve the questions with formulas. Okay, and next we'll see remaining three questions. So here the next question is what is the current gain of transistor in CC mode, given that the current gain in CB mode is 0.98. So here in this question, the question is from configurations from the transistor topic. So here we need to determine what current gain of the transistor in CC mode. So simply, so try to remember CB what value current gain ochindi. So in CB the current gain is what? Alpha. So alpha is equals to 0.98. In CE we have a current gain beta. In CC we have, so here CC we need to find. So in CC, so this is CB. So CE ochesi like beta and CC ochesi gamma. So here we need to calculate the gamma. Whereas what is the value of gamma in terms of alpha? So which is 1 by 1 minus alpha. 1 by 1 minus alpha. So whereas 1 by 1 minus 0.98. So what is the value here? 1 by 1 minus 0.98. So which is 1 by 0.02. So what is the value here? 100 by 2. 100 by 2 means what? So here it is 50. So the value of gamma is 50. So what is the answer here? C is the answer. So here for this question, just you need to know the relation between alpha, beta, gamma. Here the gamma in terms of alpha, so that is equals to 1 by 1 minus alpha. So try to concentrate in configurations also. The next question is operational amplifiers. So here the first one is non-inverting amplifier question. So non-inverting amplifier means, so here the input is given at the plus, input is given at the plus, but it is a minus 5 volts. So here what is the V naught? So V naught formula, just everyone knows, that is 1 plus RF by RI into VI. Whereas just substitute the values, 1 plus 2 by 1 into minus 5, minus 5. Whereas 3 into minus 5, 3 into minus 5, which is nothing but minus 15 volts. So what is the answer here? D is the answer. Just you need to remember the value, that is output or gain of the non-inverting amplifier, which is V0 by VI is equal to 1 plus RF by RI. But here we need to calculate the V0, but we have the values VI, RF as well as RI with these values. So just 1 plus 2 by 1 into minus 5, which is equals to minus 15 also. Only 2 seconds, 3 seconds questions these all are. And one more question. So the one more question is, so here the question is like summing amplifier. Question is like summing amplifier. So here we need to find the V naught. So in summing amplifier, V naught means, so etla teeskuntam sir, so V naught means, so here RF by RI, so that is first one. And which amplifier it is? Inverting amplifier. Try to concentrate here. Inverting amplifier. Inverting amplifier means minus. Okay, inversion. And next, so what are the, so here at the input side, so here circuit is having two input voltages. So here the first one is 7 by 2.5 into 5 millivolts. 5 millivolts. And next plus, that is RF by R1 into V1. RF by R1 into V1 plus RF by, that is 7 by R2. RF by R2, that is 3 into V2. V2 is nothing but what? 9. So just solve this. 2.5 2s are 3 3s are, so here minus 14, minus of 14 plus, so here 21. So 14 plus 21, so how much? So which is 35, minus 35 millivolts. What you will get here? Millivolts. Why? Because kilo ohms, millivolts. So here maniki units sync unnai kabatti, so we can cancel and you will get the minus 35 millivolts is the answer. So that is C is the right answer for this question. So we have discussed all these questions, but to solve these all problems like SPDCL AE, but we required only less than 5 seconds to solve all the questions, which means what? So in SPDCL AE we got 7 questions. To solve those 7 questions, mostly we required mostly 2 to 3 minutes. And so manaka analog digital electronics time saving subject. So manaku takko bits vachina sare chala simple bits vachunay kabatti. So next July 31st ki sub engineering students, so exam attend chestunnaru kabatti all sub engineering aspirants, so try to concentrate on these areas in లైక్ అనలాగ్ అండ్ డిజిటల్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్స్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ క్వైరీస్ అండ్ మీకు దేంట్లో నన్న డౌట్స్ ఉంటే సో ట్రై టు కామెంట్ సో బిలో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దట్ కామెంట్ అగైన్ ఐ విల్ ప్రొవైడ్ యూ సమ్ వీడియోస్ అండ్ ఫర్ మోర్ వీడియోస్ జస్ట్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ ది మై డ్రీమ్స్ అకాడమీ యూట్యూబ్ ఛానల్ థ్యాంక్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ నైస్ డే